I'm Rick Love for the Sonoma International Film Festival 2013 Filmmaker Interview Series here on SVTV 27. And we have with us writer-director Adam Christian Clark, who's brought a narrative feature to the film festival called Caroline and Jackie.
Hi, Rick. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. I'm from Massachusetts, grew up with the Kennedys. You
right.
have these names, Caroline and Jackie. Is it a coincidence, or are you trying to evoke that kind of Kennedy mystique?
Yeah, I think that it's a movie about two sisters dealing with an implied social pressure, maybe to be proper in the family they grew up in. So I liked those two names. It was coincidental at first, but I stuck with it when it had that meaning because I feel like it's not a movie about the Kennedys, but it evokes a properness or a certain emotional feeling that people may be able to identify with or that I'd like them to have going into the movie.
Mm-hmm. Well, certainly sets up a complicated family dynamic.
Certainly, right.
And that's really what we have. We have a very complicated relationship between two sisters. And it's interesting because I thinking about your film in the context of some of these other sister movies like Rachel Getting Married or In Her Shoes.
Right.
In those movies, you can see who the bad sister is and who the good sister is from the get-go. Your film, it's much more, I mean, it's set up that we can maybe think that, you know, which sister is going to be the bad sister, but it really changes, and so it doesn't really fit in the same dynamic as those films.
Well, thank you for saying that. You know, it's, as a filmmaker for me, the most important thing above everything, or even my own ego, I'd say, would be to make sure it's as real as I can possibly have it. Like, what I want as a viewer is for you to watch that and feel if just for a moment you're watching your own family. If I could pull it off for 30 seconds, I'd be very happy. So I think that, you know, I'm really attracted to ambiguous characters. I feel that it's sometimes emotionally more rich to have things in an honest sense. You know, if there's not always like the white hat, black hat, there's a lot of gray hats in life. So I think that, you know, you can come out of that film and I think that you at the end draw a conclusion that there's one sister that certainly like needs more help than the other. But it's ambiguous and neither of them are perfect and hopefully they're not likable characters, but hopefully you can identify with one of them or at least feel that you have some sympathy for one.
So as you were writing, you weren't thinking of, I want to make this person be the person that audiences will identify with more than another?
Well, okay, certainly at the beginning. So my goal at the beginning is for you to identify with Carolyn. You know, it's tough. She certainly is the, you know, quote unquote, crazier one of the two. So it's difficult at the beginning, but at the beginning I want you to think that Jackie has a problem and I want you to go into it like through Carolyn's eyes, but then, you know, you spend the middle part of the movie really kind of following Jackie and starting to try to identify her or sympathize with her in a more intimate way, I suppose.
And do you have sisters? Why sisters?
I have a sister, but I'm not, you know, a sister obviously, and she's 8 years younger than me, so I wouldn't say that this was inspired by her. I would say, like, in general, I'm still, as a filmmaker and as a storyteller, fascinated by women because I feel like the palette to work with is so much richer. Like, the emotional complexity of two women in a relationship, to me, just seems very intriguing. It's something that's mysterious to me, something I'm still trying to figure out. And I think there's an inalienable bond between sisters that, as a man, I'll never fully understand, but I seek to sort of explore in this film.
It does seem like sisters can do more hurtful things to each other and then still come back together than it does certainly with male friends or maybe even brothers.
Certainly, it's intense, you know, and I think that they can both love each other and hate each other with like the same malice or adulation they love themselves or hate themselves with.
Now, that's a good point, actually. They're just kind of putting out what they feel inside.
Possibly. I mean, that's one interpretation. I certainly don't have the female psyche figured out, but it's complex, I think, and I enjoy it as a subject matter.
And a nice piece of casting, David Giantoli is the lead in the hit television show Grimm. How did that work for having him in your film?
Well, actually, it was, you know, it takes so long to make an independent film. We actually like made this very fast, but, you know, in the process of shooting it and then editing it for a year, and it premiered last year at Tribeca, and it doesn't come out in the theaters until May 3rd, so there's that year too. We actually cast both David and Bitsy, who plays Jackie, they play boyfriend and girlfriend in Grimm too, before Grimm was ever shot, before it was even cast as a pilot. So they actually met on Caroline and Jackie and played boyfriend and girlfriend, and weeks after we wrapped production, David auditioned for Grimm. He got the pilot, and then a month or so after that, Bitsy screen tested to play his girlfriend in the show. And I think that they had a lot of chemistry from just...
Well, they'd worked together
before.
Right,
so I think that they had a big advantage in terms of that, and I think that's one of the reasons that worked out. Mm-hmm. But I'm happy for both of them. It's great to see them continue to work together.
Yeah, and if it helps Caroline and Jackie, all the better.
Yeah, certainly, mm-hmm. certainly.
What are you working on now?
I'm working on a couple of projects, but what I'm trying to do next, or what I'm probably going to do in July, is a movie called Fathers and Mothers. And Fathers and Mothers, actually, I this is not my first time in Sonoma, and I love Sonoma. And it actually takes place partially in Sonoma, so I hope to film around in the area. Mm-hmm. It's similar tonally to Caroline and Jackie, but Caroline and Jackie is about this group of 30-somethings. Fathers and Mothers is about a grandfather and a grandmother and a father and a mother and then a son and a daughter. It's the son goes to meet his girlfriend's family for the first time. So it's kind of like, I guess maybe in some ways it's what Caroline and Jackie's family may have been, or the larger thing, or what's implied a lot in this movie.
Mm-hmm. It's interesting because looking at the clip for the film, when I first saw it, I was wondering if this was going to have aspects of those mumblecore features, but it actually is a very nicely shot and very kind of clear, intentional film.
I appreciate you saying that. I certainly respect mumblecore films, and I understand that will very much be the voice that's probably put in textbooks to at least describe the last 10 years of American filmmaking. Mm-hmm. Myself, though, as a filmmaker, it's difficult. I don't think that it's my gift to make movies like that, and I very, 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 very much identify with the 70s American New Wave. So I love the films like the Cassavetes was making, that Robert Altman were making, where I feel like you had this balance of extreme reality where people are talking on top of each other and it seemed true to life, but there still was a huge respect for the art form or the
and
craft.
The written word.
The written word, the mm-hmm. craft of just the mise-en-scene and the lighting and just the we're going to do this and understand that if the wall is blue, it's different than if it's red.
The film is Caroline and Jackie, writer-director Adam Christian Clark. Thanks very much for coming in today.
Thanks so much. Nice meeting you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
This is the Sonoma Valley Film International Film Festival 2013 filmmaker interview series for SVTV 27. I'm Rick Love.